Michael Jackson is really one of the greatest performers that ever lived of all time, and in 2006, he announced his farewell tour with This Is It. The tour would have been a culmination of all the songs that he sang with his brothers in the Jackson 5 to when he started his own career back during the 80s and make a life of himself. While the tour itself never happened due to Michael Jackson's untimely death, having a movie feels like having a concert that no one else has seen but you. This is Michael Jackson, probably at his greatest, Michael Jackson being himself, full of energy, spunk, pop, and music. This is Michael Jackson. This is my review of Michael Jackson's This Is It.
Oh, shit. Sorry, guys. Sorry. I'm gonna keep that in the review. Sorry. You know, I myself am a Michael Jackson fan as well. I'm pretty sure all of us that grew up with his music, from Thriller to Beat It to Man in the Mirror to Earth Song to I Can't Stop Loving You. Every song of his is announced a classic. And when This Is It came out, it really was it. Because by the time that this movie came out, Michael Jackson has sadly passed away. Of course, the controversy is still going on to this day. You could talk to anybody about this controversy over, did the doctor do it? Did somebody else do it? Did Michael do it? But we're not going to talk about that. We're going to talk about his tour, the last one that he announced way back in 2006. And This Is It, which would have been a culmination of his life, work, and music put into one fantastic show. It was almost fully planned and fully ready until his death in 2009. This Is It is basically nothing more than a Michael Jackson concert that you yourself get to view, and that, man, is one of the best, you know, ever. You know, it opens up with him singing his song, You Wanna Be Starting Something, and then it just flows on from there to each different song, from Jam to Black and White. Every music video feels like you're there, man, and that's what really is good. The funniest part about this is that this is directed by Kenny Ortega. Does that name ring a bell for anybody? It should. He directed the Descendant trilogy. Yeah, if someone were to come to tell me, if the Descendants came out before Michael Jackson died, that Kenny Ortega, the director of the Descendants, was going to come in here and direct one of the best Michael Jackson movies and his tour all in one, I would have called you crazy. I would have immediately said, you're out of your mind, and just left. But honestly, he captured Michael's spirit so much that it's almost fun to watch him and how he and Michael really connect off of one another. The guitarist that worked for him does the Eddie Van Halen guitar solo from Beat It. Chord for chord. I was going to say word for word, but that's not right. Chord for chord. And it's like, especially since Eddie Van Halen has passed away, it's like, wow, man. You know, that's, wow. You know, you get to understand, like, the full enjoyment of that guitar solo. You know, again, like, you heard it back when you heard the song. It was just amazing, you know. My favorite has to be how they tried to take Thriller, one of Michael Jackson's most iconic music videos, and transform it into a 3D segment. And it looked really, really cool. And especially if, like, this actually did happen, like, if I was at this freaking concert, man, I would have been blown away by the time Thriller came out. And you could see every ounce of energy. You could feel the excitement with him. You were there, man. It was like you were there with him, experiencing this for yourself. And honestly, it's nothing more than just basically a behind-the-scenes look at one of his greatest tours, what would have been his greatest tour ever, that sadly never happened. That's like a famous singer or one of your favorite bands coming up to you and going, hey, here's a ticket, that's a Yu-Gi-Oh card, come and see this private concert by yourself, no one else, just us and you. You would have been blown away. You would be ecstatic. You'd be going to your friend going, I got a private concert and you're not invited. And you would be showboating it, but you would have the time of your life. And that's how I felt. I felt like somebody came up to me and gave me like a time traveling device and said, here, go and watch one of Michael Jackson's greatest performances ever and tell us what you think of it. And man, I am blown away. I cried a bunch of times during this. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to beat around the bush. I did. Because it's like, you get to see him, you know, again, like he would, like nothing happened, you know, back in 2009. And, you know, when he was talking about the relationship he had with his brothers when they were in the Jackson 5, him honoring his mother and father, you know, it's like such a disaster happened to a very good man. Fuck the controversies behind him. You know, you can't deny, even if you believe the controversies, I'm just bringing it up at a point. You can't deny this man was not one of the greatest performers that ever lived, period. And he showed that in this a lot. Everyone that worked with him went on the, you know, camera saying, man, this is one of the best guys that I ever worked with. This is one of the greatest performers I ever worked with. And, you know, something, it really did feel like that to me because the way, again, how he and Kenny Ortega got along so great and managed to bounce off of each other. Yeah, it was fantastic. And it's probably one of the greatest things ever. I would show you guys more, like do what I usually do behind the scenes and everything. There's not much to show. It's music video, some talking bits, music video. And that's why I want you to experience this yourself. You cannot come to me and say, well, I want a full-fledged honored review. I would love to give you that, but I'd be doing this film injustice if I did. You need to see it for yourself. It's beautiful, fantastic, greatly put together, and all in all, it's some of Michael Jackson's best work. So, even though it's not the time that basically is to celebrate his or honor his death until August, rest in peace, Mike. Rest in peace, MJ. You know, we all miss you, but your music, your children, and pretty much your children, too, will always be a part of your legacy, and we will never forget you, man. So, that's all for this episode. Thank you guys so much for listening and watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And next time, oh man, I'm going to go from a great singer to watching someone at Disney saying, hey, you know that brilliant live-action Disney film that also had some animation in it? No, not Roger Rabbit, the other one. You'll see what I mean. And lo, I'm going to try to not rant about how Disney destroyed my childhood with one of my favorite Disney films. Aside from Mary Poppins. Mary Poppins returned shit all over that legacy. But until next time, guys.